Hello, I'm Maniac, and...
I'm TD Waffle.
And this is Sins of a Solar Empire.
Now this game's still in beta, so it's going to be a little buggy.
Okay, so right now we're streaming live, and hello to everyone watching live, and we'll be uploading this to YouTube in the future. But if you want to keep up when we're doing our live streams, that'll be on either of our Twitters, which mine's is at Maniac.
Yep, at TD Waffle.
And when we're doing live, it'll be twitch.tv/Maniac. So, this game, we are going to be playing against 4 hard enemies and 4 normal enemies. Game options, you can take that, Waffle.
Alright, so game options right now, we've got unlocked teams. Teams start with peace treaties all over. Large fleet sizes. Pirates are inactive. Pirates are really nice, except for the computer on hard. They like to cheat a little bit. They'll call in the pirates as a mercenary and just destroy you. And quick start allow us to jump or start our ships off with, I think it's 2 of our frigates, and we'll start off with the cap ship.
No, it's actually you start off with the capital ship building facility and the frigate building facility already built, as well as all your mines on your home world. Basically, it's the things that you automatically build right off the bat. You also start off with, I think it's either 2 or 3 scout ships. That's all that you begin with in Quick Start. And we've got all the rates set to faster, because this game can go on for a lifetime if you put them on the slowest settings.
Yeah, it still goes on for a lifetime, because in multiplayer you can't speed up the game.
Yeah. You can in single player, though. So if you're just playing for single player, that may be something that you might like it for. Okay, so for our races, I'll be playing the Vasari. Now, I don't normally play this race. I normally play the Advent, which I will just bring them up. The races, I normally play Advent Loyalist. These are a defensive type ship class. There are the Advent Rebels who are much more offensive than the Loyalists, as all races are. You've got the offensive class and the Loyalist class. The Vasari. I am playing the Vasari Loyalist today, because I've noticed certain things when playing single player that I might enjoy. The Rebels are also just as good, but there's certain things that I'll show later on. Now, Waffle, you're playing Tech?
Today I'll be playing the Tech Loyalist. This is my typical team, and I'm going to stay with it. Because Maniac over there, he's going to be jumping over to a new class. We want to get this off the ground without a loss. So, we'll play the Loyalists. The Loyalists are a lot more defensive. You can usually put 2 star bases in a system, as where the other classes cannot. And this is very, very good whenever you've got multiple computers or other enemies coming in. You can keep them out of your jump regions. The Rebels, they're... They infiltrate and they'll take over your enemy ships, so it's great. You'll pick up ships from another class that you're not used to. You'll be able to spread factions and stuff like that very well.
Yeah. So, right, I need to quickly go select my race again, because I went into the pick race to show this. Right, Vasari Loyalists. I'm sure these are the ones I've seen. Anyway, so, I think we've covered everything. Game options. Oh, victory options, of course. Just a quick overrun of what we're doing for victory options. We've got Allied Victory on, because we'll be working together. We have Capital Victory on, which takes away your ability to change your capital planet. And if you lose your capital planet, you lose. That's it. It's over. We have everything else off. Diplomatic Victory is... It's an awkward victory condition, and it's most annoying. Flagship Victory is okay, but we're not going to play with that today, just because you tend to get your flagship and hide it.
Yeah, that's typically what happens.
Yeah. Occupation Victory, it comes down to luck with that one, on how close you are to it.
Yeah, it really depends on how much influence you have and how that's spreading, and it's usually not a good thing for my class. Not at all.
When I'm normally Advent, I'm normally quite fine with this one, because the defensive Advent spread loyally like a madman.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got Research Victory off, because I don't think I've ever played with Research Victory. I just don't see this game as being sit back, hide, research.
Yeah,
I win.
It's not worth the time. It's going to be a long game if we do that one.
Yep. So, that's all accepted. I'm going to green light.
And I'm green to go.
Okay, so, time to hit start. So,
well, Miniac usually gets in before me when he's hosting, and two, I'm on another continent. Three, my computer's just slow.
Yeah. Basically, I'll get in game, I'll get a quick peek around, but I'll be waiting for Waffle to load. If you're watching this live, you'll see it, but actually from now until he loads, it'll be cut off.
Yeah, it's not too fun. I'm almost there.
Okay.
And Miniac will give you a quick tour of what's going on with him, and then I'll show you what's going on over here.
You're quite close, actually. You're maybe... It's not instant connection. I think we'll have an enemy between us, maybe two at tops.
All right, I am in. Let's take a quick look at the world here.
So my first move is always send my scout ships out, which I was right. You get exactly two scout ships.
We got two scout ships, we got two construction frigates, and our cap ship is it's just ready to go. It's just waiting for that build.
Yep. So capital, I will be going for, well, I've not played Vasari, so I'll just take a wee minute to look over their basic caps. I think I'll go for the carrier, because when I play Advent, I always play carrier swarm. It's you know, my standard tactic. I build my colony frigate, which I believe Waffle will too be building a colony frigate. I build three scouts and five fighting frigates.
And whenever I typically launch mine, I'll launch my Amarza Dreadnought, which is a high-end attack for the tech.
1 minute, I'll scroll over and look at that, if it's out already.
Which you just popped out right here. And I will also launch 10 10 frigates.
Oh, you launch 10? I only do 5 for the initial launch, just to save on resources. Right, so the interesting thing about this game and its capital ships, every capital ship has abilities. It has 4. The 4th is only unlockable at level 6, isn't it?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah. Right. So I've got Repair Cloud, Scramble Bombers, or Micro... I'll go for that aura, because that's a permanent aura, and it's a strong thing to have. The two types of ships that carriers, all capitals get a small number of fighter craft. I don't know if that's true for tech, but
we depends on the ship, really.
Okay,
my Marza, it will have 2 by the time it caps out, so it's not that many. There's other classes that I have that will launch full-on aircraft carriers, and some are just peaceful.
Okay, so I'm taking ages to do this. I've gone slow, woman. I don't need weapons lab. Why am I building? Right, so my first move is always build 2 Imperial labs so that you can go to the Empire mode and take whichever ice or lava is near you, because you find that on average you've got one or the other. So I've got ice this time. Cool. So I start getting the ice up. I've been very slow with this get-go. It's probably due to the fact that I'm scrolling around and trying to show everything, but... Okay.
Typically, I will use this build right here with the 10 frigates and the dreadnought to rush my first base. But it looks like I don't have to do anything because they're coming to see me first.
Wow, you're right beside green there.
Yeah,
I've got at least a planet between me and dark green. But
so what I'm
going
to do is I'm going to take out green here, and then I'm going to jump to his cap planet and take that out. With capital victories on, green will be out of the game.
Yeah. So, now I've got to do the next pieces of research. So, my next build is normally double check that my homeworld's upgraded. I've normally got a planet by now. As I said, by showing everything takes a bit longer. But that's fine. I don't normally lose, so...
So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to jump over to green, and I'm just going to rail on him as hard as I can.
I'll show your fleet flying over, because that's always cool to watch. I'm over, so I see it. And as you see, his fleet is now jumping out. I didn't want to follow the frigate, I actually wanted to follow the capital. A lot of the time you won't spend in this zoomed in view that I use, just because it's not the most efficient way, it's just the fact that it looks coolest.
It looks great, but it's quite difficult to tactically manage. Whenever we get into this game, you'll have four or five different fleets going on, and it's hard to manage what's going on.
Okay, so
looks like my green right here, they're going to be tech as well, so it should be fairly even fight going on. And I took out a large number of their frigates when they jumped into mine, so it shouldn't be too bad.
I've got that up on my screen just now, that fight, because my fight was against rebels, and I'm now waiting for the colony ship to fly its slow ass over. Yeah, I've got a few scout ships out. This galaxy's looking pretty average for a single huge.
So my typical build whenever I start is one military lab, one civilian lab, because then I can get my upgrades for my ships going, and I can also get my minerals started.
See, I always go for the double civilian, as you called it, because I take it that's the tech name, just to get that ice planet right off the bat, or the lava planet. I like having those, so my next target will be a mishmash one, just an asteroid, nothing special, so.
So it looks like this guy's jumped his cap ship back into his homeworld. I'm going to bring that down, and then I'm probably going to jump out just to avoid damage.
Okay, so I'm now under attack on that world I just took, but this should be no problem whatsoever. I'll build a few more frigates back at the home world, and that'll cover that. Okay, I can only make one at the moment, but that's fine. It's fine. What my main tactic, my main trick for this is when you're in the early stages and colonizing a lot of worlds, if you're using a non-colonizing capital ship in the frigate that I have on my screen is the Vasari one. If you're using them, blow them up after one colonization and make another one. It saves on a lot of time waiting for them to gain their energy back. And right now, I am kicking the crap out of that capital ship, which is most joyous.
So it looks like I've scared him off. He's going to jump his cap ship out. It's only going to be temporary because they love just to come right back.
The computer isn't the brightest. Was that on your homeworld or no?
That's on Green's homeworld right there.
Gotcha. There's a few frigates on your ship, and it's actually on half health. You may want to warp that out and get it repaired up.
I'm gonna retreat them right now. Actually, I've got more frigates building on my homeworld right now, so we're safe there if they're following me.
Alright, so mine's just about lost its shields, and it's taken a little bit of armor damage, but I've taken their carrier down a hell of a lot more. I've purchased a level. That is one thing that you can do in this game, is purchase they're also attacking my homeworld at the same time, those jammy toss pots. I should retreat, but I don't want to. I'm gonna push this as hard as I can.
So this isn't something I typically do, is build repair platforms off the top of the game, but I've specced into them. I'm going to do it since my cap ship is so low as it is.
Okay, so I'm on my homeworld right now. I am building three frigates, because although they have a few frigates there, it's like I'm steadily winning. Oh, wrong one. Right. I want a 2-2 on my frigates and bombers. That just gives you a good spread. It doesn't make your ship too focused on dealing one type of damage or whatnot. I don't know if you do the same tactic, try to balance the number of frigates you have. And I may get a capital ship destruction this early in the game, which would be nice. It's looking like he's getting out. Yeah, he got out. Right. So now that he's out, what I have to do is go defend my homeworld. I basically was chasing him. this early stage of the game, it's normally necessary just to put ships in and the computer runs. I don't know if that's your view on it, Waffle.
Well, Green has decided to rush me again, so I'm hoping this goes well.
I'm having a quick peek over here. Yeah, he's got a just about dead.
He is really pushing hard on me.
A Carrion battlecruiser. I haven't actually seen one of those in a while. I don't think you use those very often, do you?
I do not. They are typically, this one's a balanced one. It allows you to colonize a planet and just maintain a low fleet around yourself.
Okay, interesting.
The Mars itself's built for attack, so I'm hoping just to clear this out. I've gone to spec into more laser amplification right now, because that's really all I can do. Can't get into the missile barrages yet.
Okay.
I've just leveled to 3 on my Marza. And right now it's kind of broken, where if you level your hull, your shields, they all go back to full.
Not if you spend the money to level, though. That's one thing I would like to point out. If it levels by experience, then yes, this happens. That's why you didn't see it happening to me earlier. I was leveling by spending money, which is a little bit cheap.
So my cap ship is up to 3. I should be good to take all this crap out of my gravity well.
Okay, so dark green is really attacking me now. I would normally be much more spread out than this, and I don't like not being on only 2 planets, but there's not much you can do about that. It just happened. Right, so I've started to build my warfare labs now. Weapons labs. So I will be going for... As I said at the start, I've not actually run this race before. First thing I'll actually go for is something a bit standard for this game, to be honest. Since this is the new standalone expansion, in the old game I would have gone for probably weapons developments or something along those lines, but with the addition of Titans, they're actually amazing. I'm sure Waffle will completely agree with me there. The Titans are beyond.
I have not seen the Titan for his class yet, but I'm expecting great things already.
Yeah, I was discussing it with him on our last game that we played together, and he agreed with me that they are just a tad on the overpowered side. I'm not going to lie about it. They are literally, if I am correct on how powerful the second ability is, well, it could be the first ability I take, basically a 1 point... Oh shoot, my capital's taking heavy damage, I should probably stop spraffing so much nonsense here. Quickly, you go out of there.
So my cap's already level 4, and I've killed Green's cap, so it's gotta be level 1 again. There's nowhere for him to go, he's gotta go past his other planet to level that at all. So if I jump in there, I shouldn't have very much problems with that at all.
Okay, I may lose a capital ship here because I was not paying attention. But that's fine. Oh no, it got out. If you can see life. Oh, that was scary stuff. Right, so what do I need to make? More research is needed.
So the plus with the tech is you're going to have great credits all the time. I'm up to 12,000 credits already.
Wow.
Just absolutely ridiculous. I suffer on the mineral side a little bit, but that's right now I just have one planet.
Yeah. I tend to find that sort of stuff just falls into place eventually, though I've noticed, like...
Absolutely.
So what I'm doing right now, just since my capital ship took a lot of damage and they are on one of my worlds just ransacking it and I don't have repair facilities yet, what I'm actually doing is, well, yeah, what's this? That's a siege ship. Quick, destroy that. Right, so how close is this to leveling? It's quite a distance away. Alakari will be his, apparently. Yeah, my home world will be yours, honest. Oh, wait, you did drop in another fleet. Okay, that's interesting that the computer's being quite so aggressive. Normally with me, I get lucky, and because I'm playing a different race, it's, you know, it's not normally this busy for me. I normally have defense up a lot sooner. So they've sent in a level 1 capital ship, which is worth, if you can see it on the right there, 100 experience, which would... Repair cloud. Yeah, you do repair cloud and repair yourself. That's fantastic. Yeah, my carrier has a repairing ability. That's kind of cool. Okay, so in research, I'm going to quickly do something that seems very strange. I am making 2 capital research. There is a reason for this, which I will tell you right now. The Titan takes up 2 capital slots. Now, although I'm not using those capital slots right now, I'm getting them ready so that the minute I hit 9,900 of each mineral and have the Titan building facility up, I'm literally going to drop an upgrade on the fleet logistic number, which is this number here, which we haven't really talked about, fleet supply. It's just like in a StarCraft 2 with the unit limitations and things. It's nothing that you haven't seen before in other strategy games. So I am going to warp down here, which seems weird because I don't own that planet, but when your capital is this close to death, you take the nearest jump route.
Absolutely.
Oh, I've lost it. Okay. That's fine, I can quickly sell my 1,000 crystalline, get another one.
So I was correct that earlier when I told you that the cap ship that they're going to redo on this planet would go somewhere else. It is not here. It's probably 2-3 jumps away right now, but I'm sure it's on its way back.
Yeah. So I'm really struggling in this game, which is so unusual for me. No, I need metal. So, there is a buy and sell system in this game to buy and sell your resources. Now, the market does crash from time to time if you're not careful. So, right now, what I am doing is I'm selling them. I'm just trying to balance to get as much out as I can.
So right now what I'm seeing from green is they're pumping frigates out as fast as possible while they're waiting for that cap ship to come back.
Yeah, it's basically what I'm doing as well. Okay, so is this built? Yeah, so there's also defensive structures, as you can see by my missile platform here, just completely laying siege into them. Unfortunately, it will not be enough on its own, which is why I built another capital. As quick as I could.
And my cap ship is now up to level 5. This is very early in the game for me to be this high. It's probably just because I had another planet right next to me.
Yeah.
This level 5 has also unlocked my fighter squadron. You can choose between fighter and bomber squadron. Bomber is going to allow me to just attack the planet with these squadrons. Fighter is going to allow me to attack other ships that are in my gravity well.
Yep. Okay. If I can kill this capital, the enemy should, following standard AI rules, retreat.
Typically, but not always.
Oh yeah, they fixed that in the expansion. Oh no, there goes another capital. I don't think this is my game, to be honest.
I'm hoping you stay alive. I'm working towards you, man.
Yeah.
I've left my homeworld completely vacant.
I don't know why I'm struggling so much. I think it's also to do with the fact that I am playing a new race. Okay, so capital ship's dead. Damn it.
So the cool thing with the cap ships, they can attack multiple targets at once. Later on, when we get the Titans out, it's ridiculous seeing the multitasking they do. But right now, my Capship is working on this planet. At the same time, I'm working on these facilities. I'm working on getting their factories down, and then I'm going to work on that Capship factory.
Yeah. I may actually be out of this game, Waffle. I'm afraid. We may have to restart.
I have no problems with that.
Yeah. I may just go advanced standard, and I don't know what happened here. I think I fucked myself too early by not paying enough attention to the actual game.
Yeah, that's a big thing with this game, is you have to be... There's moments when you'll sit there and just wait for these battles to drag out. You know you're going to win, but then there's moments right at the top where you're just like, you have to get these in at the precise moment, or it's going to screw your whole game.
Yeah, I'm out, dude. I'm going to have to quit, surrender.
Alright, so game one is no bueno, but
I'll get still upload two. This nonetheless, just to show that, you know, I'm not the best player when it comes. I'm a noob, and I'm proud of it.
And we're all noobs.
At life, yes.
Well, okay. Personally, too.
Right, so it'll be the same game, same rules.
Apparently, look at this game.
Yeah.
Pretty sure you're off the screen already, but there's a statistics screen. It kind of shows you what's going on. I'm going to let you know, even though he's off the screen.
I skipped it like a jackass.
Light blue, which I never saw. Apparently, he was way ahead.
Yeah.
And let's see, where was I? I was about midfield. And you know what? It's just game of the draw where, you know, he just had a bunch of planets going. Like, he probably had the hard ones on top of him. So, you know, it's early lead for him. I've been there and it's not fun.